I'm Tracy with Echelon Health. I'm the clinic coordinator and nurse. Today I have Joe Manolo with Manolo's Italian Restaurant. We're in a little town called Zephyrhills, Florida. Joe?
Hi folks, how are you today?
Joe, tell us a little bit about Manolo's and how long have you been here in business?
This restaurant has been open since 2001. So we're more or less going on 16 years here as of September 15th coming up.
And have you been in the same location for 16 years?
I've had a previous location in Dade City that I opened in 94 and sold to one of my former chefs because I wanted to give enough attention to this location. So we've been here for 16 years now.
All right, now besides pizza, what else do you serve?
We serve the full Italian menu. We serve pasta dishes, all of your classic Italian dishes, all your Parmesan dishes, seafood dishes. We even serve a good quality steak on the weekend. So we're kind of the jack of all trades when it comes to Italian cuisine. We serve the whole menu, all the way from Sicily to Northern Italy and Milan.
All right. And so do you do any special events here?
We sure do. We do quite a bit of special events. As a matter of fact, if any of you folks would like to rent out the whole restaurant for your special event, it is available for a very convenient, affordable price.
Okay. And I understand that trivia is on tonight, right? Wednesday night?
Yes, ma'am. We do quite a bit of things here. We currently host trivia every Wednesday night, and we have a great trivia.
Tonight, what are the topics? Do you know?
That's always a secret. That's always
so
presented
no
to us to the last
no
second.
Hints.
So,
all right. No well, problem. Joe is going to show us how to make a pizza. So let's get to it.
Well, our pizza, we make a traditional New York pizza. We are going to take the word out of style. We don't style after no one. We are New York at Manolo's here. Our pizza is made right here. We mix our dough and we shred our cheese. And we only use the finest of ingredients. And we've been in business for over 20 years, and that is the reason. Our product speaks for itself. And today we're going to make a pizza that is loved here in Zephyrhills, and we're going to make an 18-inch pie.
Awesome.
For you guys to taste and tell me what
wait.
You think. Excellent.
All right. So, now, Joe, do you use bread flour, or is there a particular type of flour?
We use a specific flour that's... one of our secrets I can't disclose on camera.
Okay.
What we do is the style of flour that we use is very particular to the style of pizza that we make.
Okay.
So there are very differences in flours. The flour that we use is a high gluten flour for the simple reason of the style of pizza that we make has to be a chewy pizza. It cannot break in your mouth and like crackers and so forth. You're actually chewing it. Kind of sort of similar to pretzels bagels. There you go. I'm sorry, I speak
sorry.
Four different languages on a daily basis, so every now and then I get a click.
Okay.
So we're going to start with the flour.
Right.
Usually we're going to flour the dough so it doesn't stick.
Okay.
So we'll lay this piece of dough down, and this piece of dough is particularly for an 18-inch pizza pie. So the first thing we do, there are several ways, a ton of different ways to stretch a pizza. We do it the healthiest and the cleanest way. I don't like tossing the pizza everywhere because the flour could go everywhere and it's unsanitary to make a pizza that way. So we will not be spinning pizza in this kitchen. And also, we stretch it down the way we do, as I'm demonstrating here. I'm getting all the air bubbles out of the pie, out of the dough.
Look how it's growing so fast.
In circles as I'm pressing down with my fingers flat so I don't poke a hole in it. So pretty much, it's a very simple thing. Once you get all the air out and you finish stretching it like that, we roll the dough over. We hold it on our knuckles. We stretch it in four directions. Now the middle of the dough, which you see my finger pointing to, that's already been stretched, so we're not going to stretch that anymore. Now we move to the outer crust of the dough, and we just go 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, and so on and so forth, and just keep turning it in circle in a fast manner, and boom, folks, here's what we got.
That That's amazing. Got us a go.
Just like that. Very simple. And the beauty of this way of stretching the dough is very simple. The dough and the crust is very even everywhere. So you ever had a piece of pizza where the crust was so thick and by the time you get to the middle of the pizza it's so thin?
Yes.
We don't want that. What happens with that is your sauce and everything will slide down to the middle. So we like it. I like to stretch the dough in a even manner all over. There's also the method that we use for, once again, health reasons, because we're in the kitchen. We don't want a lot of smoke. There is an old method of taking this dough and putting it right on a wood peel, or what they call a put-in, that you slide the dough with. We're not using that method. We're using a slightly cleaner method because it's much easier and much faster, and pretty much we have less work to focus on cleaning after every pizza. So the method that we will use today is what's common at most pizzerias. We're going to use a pizza screen, which will help us keep the oven deck clean. So now we're going to put the dough on the pizza screen. And once again, we're using this screen not because we don't have talent, not because we don't know how to make pie the right way. This is the right way. This is the cleaner way. So a lot of pizzerias would use the wood peel. And let me see if I can. I don't have one here. It's upstairs. So anyways, to get back to our subject.
Now, do you make your sauce here? Homemade sauce?
The dough we make here, we shred our own cheese for the simple reason of the pre-shredded cheese has a lot of fillers. The companies put a ton of rice flour in pre-shredded cheese and impurities that I don't like. So I like to shred my own blocks of cheese, and that's how we ensure that we have good quality. And our pizza sauce, of course, is made here, and we wouldn't do it any other way, seriously. So now we're gonna demonstrate how we're gonna apply the pizza sauce. So we're gonna put about 7 ounces of sauce in the middle of the pie. As you see, I piled the sauce in the middle, and once again, we're gonna go back to clockwork, circle after circle, just slightly but surely. We're gonna go around, we're gonna even it out everywhere. As you see, guys, it's a very simple thing. Don't forget, we've landed on the moon in the 60s. You can make a pizza. It's very simple. And for those people that brag about, over the years, I hear so many people brag about their grandmother's secret sauce recipe and this and that. Come on, folks, grow up, seriously. Sure, your grandmother cooked great food, but we also landed on the moon. So there is no more secrets when it comes to tomato sauces or marinara sauce or whatever you want to call it. It's the culinary arts. There is no one recipe better than the other. Sure, it all falls back to quality, but you have to understand one thing, and one thing only. We've landed on the moon. Anybody with a little bit of common sense should be able to make good sauce. So I don't want to hear anybody brag about their grandmother's secret sauce recipe. All right, now we're going to put on the cheese on the pie. As you see, I demonstrated how we laid out the sauce on the pie. Now we're going to go for cheese. And folks, you have to understand, please, please, please be very, very smart. A pizza is a little bit of everything and not too much of anything. A pizza is a little bit of sauce, a little bit of cheese, and a little bit of ingredients. Those pizzas, or pies, I should say, that people load with 15 different ingredients, what are you going to taste? What are you going to enjoy? So I don't recommend a lot of toppings on the pie. I always recommend a simple recipe. But for those who don't like that and have a different palate, I understand. You don't have to agree with what I'm saying in regard to how much stuff you can put on the pizza, or toppings, I should say. So here is a wonderful amount of cheese, mozzarella cheese, that we put on the pie. And now we're just going to make pepperoni, just a classic, an everyday pizza. And for pepperoni, as I demonstrated to you guys, it's a very simple, when you're making a pizza, you're just going in circles. So that's what I want you to remember. We're going in circles. So we apply the pepperoni evenly.
Joe, who taught you how to cook?
Family? I was taught, yes, I was many, many years ago when I was young, when we first moved, we were living in New York, and above a pizzeria that belonged to a relative of mine, and I was spinning pies at the age of 11. At the age of 12, they've seen how good I was, they gave me a shift, but I didn't honor my work. I was still a child and I wanted to play and But every now and then when I wanted a pizza, I'd go in there and make it for myself, and I end up working for 2-3 hours to pay for my pizza as a child. So we're going in circles with the pepperoni. And there you go, guys. Now we're gonna take this pie here. We're gonna put it in the oven. Thank you, ma'am. We're gonna put it in the oven. And we're gonna take about 8 to 10 minutes. The oven usually will bake it in 5 to 6 minutes here, but our hot oven doesn't come on till later on. But okay. Here's what we got. We got a few more minutes, but I just wanna show you what it looks like. And like I said, this pizza is our style. We know what works for us here in Florida. This pie is pretty much, some people brag about how thin the pizza is, some people brag about how thick it is and how much. We like to please everybody. So what we do with this pie, which I left out earlier, our pizza is not too thick and not too thin. It's right in the middle, which we give. In the South here of the United States, people grew up on biscuits and cornbread and so much, so they enjoy that style of stuff. So I've developed this pizza here and this recipe that works for us. So we're gonna put it back in the oven for a few more minutes and we're good to go.
All right, guys,
we're going to check on the pizza. It looks like it's done. We're just gonna go ahead and...
It looks delicious.
We're gonna put it right on the stone for 45 seconds.
Okay, what does that do?
Make that crispy? Actually gives it a thinner, the bottom of the crust, it makes it crispier.
Okay.
It makes it also chewier. It bakes it through. And folks, trust me, you don't want to eat an underbaked pizza. It will ruin your stomach. Flour, no matter what kind it is, has natural gluten in it. And some flours have extra gluten and whatnot. You don't want dough just, it's like chewing gum, swallowing chewing gum. That's what you'll end up with. So always ask for your pizza well done. And that's what I recommend.
I've had doughy pizza before. It's not good.
It's not good for your stomach. It will upset your stomach. It'll take a while for it. So here we are here. We're going to take a look at the crust and see if it's to our liking, meaning the bottom of the pizza. I'm going to say I give it another 30 more seconds, and we're ready to eat pizza. Are you ready? Awesome. Let's see that smile. Show the camera the smile.
No.
Well, we made the pizza for you.
How many pizzas can you put this oven in?
This is the biggest pie we can serve. We can do up to 4 in this, but we also have a deck here and 2 more decks there.
Oh, wow.
So we're set up for a large volume if we have to.
What do you, is that pizza your, is that the thing, is that what you sell most of? Or
well,
something else?
We sell, I'm going to say pizza is about 30 to 35% of our sales, a little bit of everything. Now we're gonna slice the pie, as you see. We go in the middle here. Boom, folks. We have some pie now.
Looks delicious. Thank you, Joe.
Bon appetito. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
Because he missed the scenery, the native dances and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong. 'Cause now it's
hey mambo, mambo Italiano, hey mambo, mambo Italiano, go go go. Mixed up a Siciliana, all you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy with a hey mambo. Don't wanna tarantala, hey hey mambo. No more mozzarella, hey mambo. Mambo Italiano.